Police have revealed their hand after yesterday's sensational arrest of a couple in the state's southwest over the murder of young mother Amber Haigh 20 years ago. Despite a $1 million reward for help, detectives will rest their case on a purchase receipt for a chainsaw and extraordinary phone taps where the pair allegedly discussed feeding human remains to pigs.
They are husband and wife, same murder charges, but Robert and Anne Geeves are now represented by different lawyers.
Is it unusual that husband and wife should seek separate representation?
No comment.
Robert Geeves was allegedly asking his wife not to roll on him and says he doesn't want to go to jail. But the most startling covert transcripts presented to Cowra Court allege what happened to 19-year-old Amber Haigh when she was living with the pair 20 years ago. Where are we going to take the rest of her now? Anne Geeves is alleged to have asked her husband. Just want to give it to the pigs out the back?
Police say evidence from those telephone intercepts strongly implies Amber Haigh was dismembered and discarded after she was killed, and that that evidence is firmed up by a receipt police have seized of a purchase made by Robert Geeves in the days after Amber went missing. It was for a chainsaw.
An inquest once found Robert Geeves had fathered Amber's infant son, and allegations today reveal a large amount of witness accounts surrounding the accused's controlling behaviour and grooming. His lawyer told the court that a 1993 charge over the shotgun death of another woman were murder and manslaughter charges, and he was found not guilty on both. Margaret Little turned up for the bail hearing for legal reasons we cannot report why.
Blessing the seam, being actually brought to court and have to answer to somebody after so many years.
For Anne Geeves.
No release application today, why is that?
Mrs. Geeves has serious medical complaints and I need medical reports.
She'll seek bail in 2 weeks. Homicide investigators will no doubt seek to speak with her again. In Cowra, Robert Ovadia, 7 News.